Sattriya dance comes from Assam, northeast of India. Its origin goes back to the late 15th century. This dance form was evolved by Vaishnavite saint called Sri Khonkordeo in Assam. At the time, the political context was that there was a lot of social chaos. There was a political unrest in that society at that time. And Khonkordeo developed this new Vaishnavism movement, which is where he developed this unique form of getting people together of all caste and creed, sitting down, doing simple rituals in the name of God Krishna, coming down prayer. And this music and dance and theatre was a form of, you know, bringing the common people to understand the religious context, what he was going for. Of course, over the many years, Sattriya dance is still preserved and performed by male monks in the monasteries called the Hotros. About 4 or 5 decades back, some of the gurus started coming out from the sattras to the cities, and they started teaching women as well, because the women dancing in Sattriya is a very recent tradition. It follows a music called Borgit music, which is another form of Assamese classical music, and you have different instruments like the call, which is kind of a drum, two-faced drum call, kudital, kind of goes or a cymbal plays. You use flute for music, there is singing, and the dance movements are very lyrical and it's graceful, and again it has the whole idea is to sing and dance in praise of Krishna. Hastas, the gestures used in the story of the Dashavatar, or the 10 incarnations of Vishnu. Dashavatar. Matsya, the fish. Kurma, the tortoise. Varaha, the boar. Narasimha, half man and half lion, the tongue. Vamana is the dwarf. Parashurama, one who holds the axe. Balarama holds the plough. Buddha, Lord Buddha, and Kalki, one who rides on a horse and carries the sword. My first exposure to dance was through my mother. She was dancing, and when she started teaching dance, I used to go and watch her dance, teaching to her students, and she was performing. So for me, I was kind of born into this world of dance and music. I started getting training in Bharatanatyam quite an early age, and then moved on to do my Arangetram from the age of 9 years in Chennai under the great gurus of Kalakshetra, where my mother learned dance. I also started taking lessons in Hotria dance from my mother and also from other traditional gurus. And for me, these were two different languages in terms of, you know, as I speak English, as I speak Assamese. For me, there were two languages. Hotria was my mother tongue and Bharatanatyam was my adopted language. So I had the privilege of learning from gurus regularly back in Chennai and back in Assam.